Shabbat Shalom. Before we give any further instructions, please turn to page 29 and then we'll talk. Shabbat Shalom to everybody. Before we even begin any conversations, we must heed the first commandment that was handed down to us from Sinai, and that is, shut thine cell phones and electronic objects, any of them, all of them, unless you are a doctor on call, in which case it can vibrate. Nobody else really needs to have their phones on, especially on such an august occasion. So, Boker Tov, I'm Dani, this is Sarah, and that's Mark, and everybody else you're going to meet right now, because I'm going to bring them up here and ask for Lori and David and Noah who is already up here, to come up for the donning of the talit for the first time. I will explain as we go along. Please make your, you can come up here. Those of you who are frum in any way, who are observant, this is a weird service. Those of you who are not observant at all, this is a real weird service. Those of you who are not Jewish, this is a weird service. This is strange for everybody because this is a liberal, Hasidish, eclectic thing that we do here with adjustments for a bar mitzvah, for a full Torah reading and haftarah. So forgive us, I will always give pages and there are transliterations in the prayer book itself and some translations, and I will explain certain things as we go along, but we are so, so delighted to have you here and so delighted to have as our second first bar mitzvah. We had one a month ago, which was someone's second bat mitzvah. So 70 years after the first one, which is awesome. And this is the first bar mitzvah. So here we are. So if you have it.
I'm going to wait to take it out for 1 second. I want to say something real quick. Okay. Come here, my son. I guarantee you we will cry before today's over.
Okay.
And I'm going to read. Noah, do you know what this is?
No idea.
Okay. This is a tuning fork. Musicians carry these around all the time, so they always have a source to remember what the sound of, in this case, an A is. They know the sound already deep inside them, but this device reminds them how to call it forth. It brings them in tune with the vibration of the note. These are the four tzitzit on your talit. Tzitzit, the numerical value of tzitzit in Hebrew is 600. And each one of these tassels has 5 knots and 8 strings. And that equals 13. So total, it's 613. And the importance of that is, like the tuning fork, this talit and these tzitzit, really the tzitzit, are a reminder for us to stay in the vibration and in tune with the 613 commandments. Look, I went off script. But I think I'm doing okay. And like the tuning fork, the talit is a reminder to bring us in tune with the spiritual connection to the oneness of the universe. Your mother and I designed this talit specifically for you, and found an amazing artist in Boston to weave it for you, because we want you to always remember not just the 613 mitzvot, but the timeless nature of who we are and your place in the world and the universe.
Oh Lord, my God, thou art very great. Thou art clothed with honor and majesty, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain. So you are now going to say Baruch
Atah
Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kitshanu B'mitzvotav V'tzivanu Lehit'atef
Batzitzit.
There you go. Give it a kiss. Round your shoulders. That's hard. This one. Now just say a little prayer for yourself quietly here. Whatever it is that you say to yourself. When you're ready, I'll take it off. Put it here. And you take this. Now it gets a little bit. Throw. shoulder. You take that and look for the other back shoulder. Hold it this way. And there you go. Now, oof, wow, look at this.
These were given to you by a cousin, by Cousin Esther and her family.
So that here so that it won't come off. And let me comfort you and let you know that it will come off even though you have the clips on.
Great.
This is my experience. That's why I don't even have we're bound to each other with mitzvot. Okay. We are now on page 30, please. Page 30. We open our prayers in a Jewish synagogue with words that were not only written by someone not Jewish, they were written by someone who came to curse us and ended up blessing us. The power of turning a curse into a blessing is one of the most important things that we get to do as Jews in this world. Matov.
Oh,
Harav Kook, the great, great Harav Kook, the father, said there are four different levels of song in the world, and the highest level in which a human being rises beyond their own personal song and beyond the song of their people and beyond the song of the universe even. At that point, a person becomes, instead of Yisrael, take the same letters and change them to Shir-El. One becomes a song of God. When we sing with intent, when we sing with Kavanah, it becomes a song of God. And this is what we're here to do, is just to sing. And I really don't care if anybody does or does not believe in God. God doesn't care. I don't care. It's irrelevant. Still sing as though you believe in God. And who knows what might happen. Asher Yatzar and Elohai Neshama is on page 31, thanking God for creating us with holes, holes, hollows, hollows, through which not only do we take physical substance, sustenance, but also the spiritual, the emotional, the psychological sustenance. Page 31.
Asher yatzar et adam bechokhmah uvara bo nekavim nekavim chalulim chalulim. Now you please. Asher yatzar et adam bechokhmah uvarach bo nekavim, nekavim, chalulim, chalulim. Galuri ve'yadua, lifnei kise kevodecha, she'im ipateach echad mehem, o yisatem echad mehem. אי אפשר להתקיים ולעמוד לפניך. ברוך אתה אדוני, רופא כל בשר ומחיל לעשות.
אלוהי
again, please. Asher yatzar et adam bechokhmah uvarach bo nekavim, nekavim, chalulim, chalulim. Yaduah lifnei kise kevodecha. Baruch Ata Adonai, Rofe Kol Basar, Umafin Hasud.
So sweet to sing like that, because I'm seeing such sweet faces out there, and I'm hearing some sweet voices besides members of our volunteer choir who are always with us and sit with you so that the room will be tuneful, but also to have my colleague and my friend Bat-Ami, Cantor Bat-Ami, be here is such a pleasure. Thank you, Bruchati. It's really a blessing to us, both seeing your beautiful, smiling, and absolutely wonderful face, and that sound that comes out of it, which is one of those rare combinations that happen. Baruch Shamar, blessed is the one who spoke and the world came to be. I cannot emphasize enough how important that is, that we absolutely affirm that God literally, it's not even God spoke and the world came to be. Amar vehaya, said and was. That's instantaneous. God speaks, the world is. Chayim v'mavet b'yad ha'lashon. Life and death are in the provenance of the tongue. The words we use in this world matter. Words actually matter because they can create or they can destroy. Baruch Shamar, page 32.
Baruch Shamar Vaya Olam. Baruch Shamar Vaya Olam. Baruch Oseh Bereshit, Baruch Omer Veoseh, Baruch Oseh Umkayem, Baruch Merachem Al Haaretz, Baruch Merachem Al Habriot, Baruch Meshalem Sachar Tov Mireal, Baruch Chai La'ad V'Kayam La'Netzach, Baruch Kodem Matzil, Baruch Shemo.
On page 33, we find the Hodula Adonai Kito from Psalm 136. I was compassionate and I selected some of my favorite passages from it, so you shouldn't have to, God forbid, say all the tefillah, because we do not want to tax liberal Jews too much on a Shabbat morning. But we want to be thankful. We want to really, really be filled with gratitude. And gratitude, as I always tell people who know me, does not come easily for me in the morning. And the rabbis knew that, and that's why they stuck all the gratitude prayers in the morning, knowing that it would be hard to get up and go, oh, I'm feeling so wonderful, thank you, thank you, thank you. So exactly when it's difficult, that's when those prayers are put there. Everything that's in the Torah is there because it's not obvious. Because it's not obvious. And anytime you come across anything in these prayers this morning that is difficult for you or makes you feel like, I don't know, that's your prayer, that's your gift, that's your personal gift. That's the one you're supposed to look at. That's the one that you're actually supposed to read very carefully. And the more irritating, the more difficult, the better. And then, of course, the more grateful we should be. So, Hodu L'Adonai.
Hodu L'Adonai Ki Tov Ki L'Olam Hasdo. Hodu L'Elohei Ha'Elohim Ki L'Olam Hasdo. Ki L'Olam Hasdo. Hodu L'Adonai Adonim, Ki L'Olam Hasdo. Le'Oseh Nifla'ot Gedolot Levado, Ki L'Olam Hasdo. Ki L'Olam Hasdo. Ki L'Olam Hasdo. Ki L'Olam Hasdo. Hodu L'Adonai Ki Tov, Ki L'Olam Hasdo. Gozer yam suf yitzarim Ki l'olam chasdo Mehevi Yisrael v'tupo Ki l'olam chasdo Ki l'olam chasdo Lemolich amo b'midbar Ki l'olam chasdo Lemakeh melachim gedolim Ki l'olam chasdo Ki l'olam chasdo Oh, natan artzam lenachala
ki olam kasto
nachala leIsrael avedo
ki olam kasto ki olam kasto
nohotem lechem lechol basar
ki olam kasto
bohodu leel hashamay
ki olam kasto ki olam kasto
On page 35, page 35, please, and we're looking at Psalm 92, a psalm for the Sabbath, Mizmor Shir Leyom HaShabbat. Mizmor Shir Leyom HaShabbat, Tov Laudot Ladonai, Ulezamer Leshimcha Elyon, Leagid Baboker Chasdecha, Veemunatcha Balelot, Ale Asor Veale Navel, Ale Higayon Bechinor, כי שמחתני אדוני בפועליך, במעשה ידיך ארנן. מה גדלו מעשיך אדוני, מאוד עמקו מחשבותיך. איש בער לא ידע, וכסיל לא יבין את זאת. בפרוח רשעים כמו עשב, ויציצו כל פועלי אבן, להישם דם עדי עד, ואתה מרום לעולם, אדוני, כי הנה אויביך, אדוני, כי הנה אויביך יובדו, יתפרדו כל פועלי אבן, ותרם פיריהם קרני, בלותי בשמן רענן, ותבט עיניי בשוריי, בקמים עליי מרעים, תשמע נא אוזני. צפדי בתמר Sammy and Avi to come and lead us in the Ashrei, which can be found on page 36. Ashrei, page 36.
Ashrei Yoshev Betecha, Od Yehallelucha Sela.
Ashrei Ha'am Shekach Alo, Ashrei Ha'am Shadonai Elohav.
Tehillah David Aramichalo, Elohai HaMelech, Barucha Shimcha Leolam Vaed.
Bechol Yom Avarchecha, Barucha Shimcha Leolam Vaed.
Gedol Adonai Olam Meod, Eligdolato In Cheker.
Dor Ledor Yishabach Masecha, Ugvuratecha Yavidu.
Hadar Kevototecha, Udivrei Niflotecha Asicha.
Yeshusuratecha Yomeru, Ugulatcha Asaprena.
Shechar Abtucha Yabiru, Vetzidchatcha Yeraninu.
Chanun Verachum Adonai, Erech Apayim Ugdal Chasen.
Tov Adonai Lakol, Verachav Al Kol Ma'asav.
Yoducha Adonai Kol Ma'asecha, V'chasidecha Yevarchucha.
Kevod Malchucha Yomeru, Ugvuratcha Yedaberu.
Leodia Livni Adam Gevurotav, Ukvod Hadar Malchuto.
Malchutcha Malchut Kol Amim, Namshatecha bechol dor ador.
Somech Adonai lechol hanoflim, bezokef lechol hakepufim.
Einecho elecha yisaberu, ve'atanu ten lahem etocham biyuto.
Poteach et yadecha, masvi'a etocha eratzon.
Tzadik Adonai bechol derachav, v'chasid bechol ma'asav.
Karov Adonai lechol korav, lechol asher yikra'u b'emet.
Ratzon yireyav yaseh, et shavatam yishmam v'yoshiyem.
Shomer Adonai et kol ohavav, ve'et kol harshayim yashmid.
Tehilat Adonai yedaber piv, yivarech kol baser shem kachol olam ba'ed.
V'anachnu nevarech yah, me'ata ve'ad olam.
Page 38.
Hallelu, hallelu, hallelu. Hallelu, hallelu, hallelu. Hallelu, hallelu, hallelu. Hallelu, hallelu, hallelu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah,
We are now on page 39. Please rise. We have the Yotzer O prayer on page 39, in which it says, Hamir la'aretz veladarim aleha berachamim. God, normally it's translated, illuminates the earth and those who dwell upon it. Usually we say, with mercy, that God with mercy shines light on the earth and those who dwell upon it. But the Hebrew suggests something else. Ladarim aleha berachamim. God shines light to those who dwell mercifully upon the earth. And if we do not dwell mercifully upon the earth, not much light is going to happen. No matter how gracious and wonderful God is, it is up to us to dwell mercifully upon the earth. And then, Me'ir la'aretz veladarim aleha. Ruch ata Adonai yitzir ha'merot. Page 41. Ahava rabba ahavtanu Adonai Eloheinu chemla gdola v'yitra chamalta aleinu. בעבור אבותינו ואימותינו שבטחו בך ותלמדם חוקי חיים, כן תחננו ותלמדנו המרחם רחם עלינו, ותן בליבנו להבין ולהשכיל, לשמוע, ללמוד וללמד, לשמור ולעשות ולקיים את כל דברי תלמוד תורתך באהבה. All these mitzvot that we are doing, all this work that we do, had better be for the sake of love and the sake of peace, or else better we shouldn't do it. So here we are on page 42.
Ve'aher einenu betoratecha, nedabek libenu b'mitzvotecha, ve'yached levavenu be'ahava u'yira et shemecha, ve'lo
Now this one is specially for you. Before we do the Shema, I want you to take the four corners of your tallit.
Yeah.
You see the tzitziot?
Yeah. Okay.
Right. Four corners. See? Get them together like this. Watch. See the way I'm doing it?
Yeah.
Two from the bottom and two from the top. There you go. Bind them together. Then get this one for you from that one there. Can you hold it like that? And when I'll tell you, you'll kiss the tzitzit, because Judaism is a tactile religion. We kiss everything. Ve'avienu leshalom me'arba kanfot ha'aretz, gather us for the sake of peace from the four corners of the earth. Ve'tolichenu komimiyut le'artzenu, and lead us upright to our homeland. Ki el po'el yeshuot ata, uvanu b'charta mikol am ve'lashon, For you are a saving God, and you have chosen us from all nations and languages. And you have brought us near to your great name, Selah, in truth. To thank you and proclaim your oneness with love. Baruch ata Adonai, abocher ba'amo Yisrael be'ahava. Now you can say the Shema. Page 44.
Shema Yisrael.
Et Adonai Elohecha, b'chol levavcha, u'chol nafshecha, u'chol me'odecha, v'chayu hadvarim ha'elech, asher anohi mitzavcha, hayom alevavecha, v'shinatam levanecha, v'dibartam b'am, v'shivtecha b'veitecha, u'vlechtecha v'aderech, Uvshoch becha, uvkumecha, uvshartam leot al yadecha, becha hiu totafot beinecha, uvtavtam hamezuzo beitecha, uvisharecha.
Lema'am tisgeru basitem et kol mitzvotai, leitem kedoshim Elohim, ani. Ani Adonai Elohechem.
Emet. So here's where normally when we do a Shabbat in the city, we spend a lot of time talking about Torah. And so we do a little bit shorter in places leading up to that. But today, it's a whole different story. Today there's chanting, today there's aliyot, today there's a Dvar Torah from the Bar Mitzvah. So what we are going to do is on page 45, we're going to sing one of our favorite Hasidic, really greatest Hasidic songs, Tzama Nafshi, from the Belz Hasidim. It's an awesome, awesome piece of liturgy by Avraham Ibn Ezra, who was one of the great poets and Torah commentators of his time, and then made the terrible mistake of criticizing rabbis in his generation about their choice of liturgy in the prayer book, and was swiftly excised from the prayer book, which I guess goes to teach us certain things. I'm not sure that we want to learn them, actually, but I am in the society that's pushing for Avraham Ibn Ezra to come right back into the Siddur, not just for the Zmirot, and not just for the Torah commentary, but to put him back in there, because I like critics. I like people who ask questions and people who question authority. So Tzama Nafshi, after we're done with Tzama Nafshi, here's what we're going to do. We have a silent Amidah, a short silent Amidah. And you can turn for that if you want to see the actual liturgy for that. You can turn to the silent Amidah on page 21, even though that's an evening Amidah. So for those of you know what to shift on the Shabbat morning from the Shabbat evening. But the Amidah is there if you wish it. Silent Amidah, after which we begin the Torah service. Okay? So Tzama Nafshi, silent Amidah, and then Torah service.
Tzama Nafshi, Tzama Nafshi, L'Elohim L'Echai. Tzama Nafshi, L'Elohim L'Echai. Libi, libi, libi ubsari, Yoveru. Echad verani Amar Chai ani
kilo kilo ireni adam vechai oy barako mechol vochma meitzam zima meod nerama meinei kolcha
samanashi samanashi Elohim elechai samanashi Sari Alleluia
Please rise. may be seated. Don't get used to it, it's just momentary. There'll be a lot of standing up again, but in the meantime, sit down for a second. We now find ourselves on page 50. Page 50 and 51 is where we are going to start our Torah service. We are today going to be in the parasha of Vayechi, and he lived. The last parasha in the book of Bereshit, in the book of Genesis, which is why at the end Noah is going to say Chazak, Chazak, v'nitchazek. He's going to say, let us be strengthened and be strong, which we do every time we finish reading one of the five books of the Torah. This last portion is very profound. Noah has beautiful stuff he's going to share with you. I just want to mention one aspect of it, because it's the time in which Jacob blesses his sons, about which, again, Noah is going to speak in a beautiful way. For my issue is, what's in a name? And when we think about how people name themselves or name their kids in America, is very different than how we name kids Jewishly or biblically. Now, Noah's name, what a sweet name to get. And if you look at Noah, Kishmo Kenhu, he is exactly as his name. Noah means pleasant, comfortable, easy to get along with, sweet. And it just exudes from him. No? I mean, it's just, there you are, you look at him, you go, Noah, it's so nice. It's just, it's really, I get a name from my parents, what? Dan. Dan, oi, oi, oi. It says, I know, because it says in the Torah, Dan yadin amo ke'echad shiftei Israel. Dan will judge his people. And here's the question, as though he is one of the tribes of Israel, is one way of looking at it, or like all the tribes of Israel are one. But both are correct. Both are correct if you look at them. So my name is what you call a stumbling block. I studied for 14 years with a Zen master whose teacher named him Dainin Katagiri Roshi. Dainin means great patience. I asked him why his teacher gave him that. He said, because I was the absolute most impetuous, restless, really ADD student my teacher had ever had. So he named me Great Patience. And for the rest of my life, all I've been doing is struggling. And that's what I've been doing with my name. I am by nature extraordinarily judgmental, and I have had to work all my life to not be as my name is, but to overcome my name. One way or another, a blessing. You get a blessing being called Noach, or you get a blessing being called Dan, and you have to struggle with it all your life. So there we have it. We are in Parashat Vayechi, and we are going to begin the Torah service, page 50.
Ein kamocha ba'elohim Adonai, ve'ein kema'asecha, malchutecha malchut kol olamim, u'memshaltecha bechol dor vador. Adonai melech, Adonai malach, Adonai imloch le'olam va'ed, Adonai oz le'amo yiten, Adonai yevarech et amo b'shalom.
And I would like to invite up now, for opening the ark, Isabella and Jessica and Levi. I also, Noah is already here, and I also want Mark Safian and Scott and Catherine to be up here now to be prepared for the opening and the closing of the ark. Please come up.
Abba Rahamim, etiva birtzonecha etzion. Tivenechomot Yerushalayim, tivenechomot Yerushalayim. Ki becha levad batachnu, melech el ram v'nisa adon or.
Olamim. Who is opening the ark? Please open it now.
Vayehi bin Soharon, Vayomer Moshe, Kuma. Baruch Shenatan Torah Torah Baruch Shenatan Torah Torah Le'amo Yisrael Bikedushato Shema Yisrael Adonai Adonai Echad, Echad Eloheinu, Gadol Adoneinu, Kadosh Shemo.
Turn around this way and we'll bow together.
Gadol Adonai Iti, Uneron Memashemo Yachdav, Lecha Adonai Hagedul. Husana ve'anati talem Elechamda libi Husana ve'anati talem Elechamda Chamda libi Husana ve'anati talem Elechamda libi Husana ve'anati talem Elechamda chamda libi Usana ve'al natitalem Elechamda chamda libi Usana ve'al natitalem Elechamda libi Usana ve'al natitalem Elechamda chamda libi Usana ve'anna titalem Eile chamda, chamda libi Usana ve'anna titalem Eile chamda libi Usana ve'anna
Thank you. How does breathing begin?
Exhaling.
Okay. There you go. For the honor of the first Aliyah, I would like to call up Bill and Sandy Goodglick.
Yamtu Zeev Ben Shimshon Verachel Vesara Bat Yosef Masha Rochel Lalia Rishon Ala Torah.
Baruch
Adonai Hamvorach Leolam Vaed.
Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Leolam Vaed. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Hamim Venatan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Ata Adonai Lotein HaTorah.
Amen. Amen. Vaya'al Yosef Likbor Et Aviv Vaya'alu Ito Kol Avde Faro Zikne Veito Veho Zikne Eretz Mitzrayim Veho Beit Yosef Vechavu Veit Aviv Rak tapam vitzonam uvkaram azvu be'eretz Goshen vayalimo gam rechev gam parshim vayehi hamachane kaved meyod.
Asher natan lanu Torat emet v'chaye olam nata b'tochenu Baruch ata Adonai notein haTorah.
Amen.
For the honor of the second Aliyah, I'd like to call up Barbara and Michael Kessler and Lois and Samara Sapien.
Tamodna basha bat Hadassah v'Moshe Michal ben Moshe HaKohen v'Manya u'Miriam bat Sara Samara l'Aliyah Shniya l'Torah.
Baruch
Adonai Amvorach Leolam Vaed. Baruch Adonai Amvorach Leolam Vaed. Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam
אשר בחר בנו מכל העמים ונתן לנו את תורתו. ברוך אתה אדוני נותן התורה.
אמן.
אמן. ויבואו עד גורן האתד אשר בעבר הירדן ויספדו שם מספד גדול וכבד מאוד ויעש לאביו אבל שבעת ימים וירא יושב הארץ הכנעני את האבל וגורן האתד ויאמרו אבל כבד זה למצרים על כן קרא שמה אבל מצרים אשר בעבר הירדן ויסעו בניו לו כן כאשר ציוום ויסעו אותו בניו ארץ הכנען ויקברו אותו במערת שדה המכפלה אשר קנה אברהם את השדה לאחוזת קבר מת עפרון החיתי על פני ממרא וישוב יוסף מצרים הוא ואחיו וכל העולים איתו לקבור את אביו אחרי קברו את אביו.
יישר כוח.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam Hashem Natan Lanu Torat Emet Bahaye Olam Nachach Misokeinu Baruch Ata Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen.
Yisha Koach. Koach. For the honor of the third Aliyah, I would like to call up Susanna Heschel, Robert and Debbie Ogner. עמוד נא יעמדו חנה שושנה בת הרב אברהם יהושע השל וברוך בן ישראל ובתיה ודבורה בת גרשון אליאס לעלייה השלישית לתורה.
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Le'olam Va'ed
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Le'olam Va'ed Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam Asher Barach Banu Mikol Amim V'nasan Lanu Estraso Baruch Ata Adonai Nosein HaTorah.
Amen. Vayiru Ake Yosef Kimet Avichem ויאמרו לו ישמענו יוסף וכשב ישיב לנו את כל הרעה אשר גמלנו אותו ויצבו אל יוסף לאמור אביך ציווה לפני מותו לאמור כה תאמרו ליוסף אנא Sana Pesha Acheha Piatatam Kira Agimaluka Piata Sana Lefesha of Day Loke Avika Vayev Yosef Bidabiram Ela
Shakuach.
Baruch Atad
Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam Hashana Son Lanu Toras Emes V'chaye Olam Nata B'sochenu Baruch Ata Adonai Masein HaTorah
Amen. And I would like to ask you to remain here, because after the third Aliyah we would like to do a Misha Berach. If there are people who want to be acknowledged, I want to acknowledge Larry Rosenstein. But other than that, I'll look at the room, and because there's so many of you, if you wish to say the names out loud, say them at once. Hashem Yitbarach can sort it out. Okay? So I'll look around the room. If you have anyone you want to bless for healing, whether spiritually or physically, please do so now.
Mi shebera avoteinu mekor habracha leimoteinu. May the source of strength who bless the ones before us, help us find the courage to make our lives a blessing, and let us say Amen. Mi sheberach imoteinu mekor habracha avoteinu. Bless those in need of healing with refuah shlema, the renewal of body, the renewal of spirit, and let us say Amen.
El Narchan Alehem, may they be healed speedily. Shakoach. For the honor of the fourth Aliyah, I would like to call up David and Lori. Yamtu David Chaim Shimon ben Yaakov Menachem veBatya Ahuva veShana Bat Miriam uMoshe laAliyah Chamish Arevit laTorah.
Baruch Adonai Baruch Le'olam Va'ed
Baruch Adonai Baruch Le'olam Va'ed Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Hamim V'natan Lanu Et Torato Baruch Ata Adonai Shmoten HaTorah
Amen.
Amen. Vayohu gam echad, vayiplu lefanav, vayomiru hinenu lecha leavadim, vayomer aleichem Yosef al tirau ki hatachat Elohim ani, ve'atem hashavtem alai ra Elohim. Hashava l'tova l'man aso kayom hazeh l'chakayot amrav ve'ata al tira'u anohi ahokel erchem ve'etapahem v'nachem otam v'edaber alibam.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Asher natan lanu Torah demet v'chaye olam nata b'tochenu Baruch atah Adonai, noten haTorah.
Amen.
Yisher koach. And for the honor of the final fifth aliyah, Yamod, 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 Yamod HaBar Mitzvah, Noach Moshe Aaron, Ben David Chaim, Shimon Veshana, Laliyah Chamishit LaTorah.
Baruch et Adonai Hamvarach.
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Le'olam Va'ed.
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Ha'amim V'natan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Ata Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen.
Amen. Vayeshev Yosef b'Mitzrayim, hu uveit aviv. Vayehi Yosef me'ava esir shanim. Vayar Yosef le'Ephraim b'nei shileshim. Gam b'nei Machir b'Menashe yuldu abirkei Yosef. Vayomer Yosef elikav anohi met. Velohim pakod yifkod etchem veha'ela etchem min ha'aret hazot el ha'aret asher nishba le'Avraham li'Yitzhak u'Yaakov v'yashba Yosef epenei Yisrael lemor pakod yifkod Elohim etchem veha'ela etchem ve'alitem et atzmotai mizeh. Vayamot Yosef b'me'ava eser shanim. Vayachantu oto vayisem ba'aron b'mitzrayim. Chazak, chazak, v'ni chazek.
Shav koach. Yeah. I would like to call up Joe, Kevin, Asher, Ryan, and Huxley to come up here, please, for Hagba.
Yes, it's okay, do it.
Baruch Ata Adonai, Elohim, Melech Olam, Asher, Natan, Lanu, Torat, Emet, Behaye, Olam, Nata, Betokenu, Baruch Ata Adonai, Noten HaTorah.
Amen.
Three columns, and thank God you're not Sephardic, or you would have had to show five. So let's do that. Please rise.
Bezor Torah Asher Samoshe Yifei Bnei Yisrael Ovi Adonai Be'ad Moshe.
Who's holding it? Thank you.
this on here.
Baruch atah Adonai Elokeinu Melech haolam Asher bachar binviim tovim Beratza v'divrehem ha'ne'emarim ve'emet Baruch atah Adonai Haboker b'Torah uv'Moshe avdo Uvishrael amo, uvin vie ha'emet vat sedek. Vayishkav David im avotav, vayikaver peir David. Bekayamim asher malach David al Yisrael arba'im shana. Bechevron malach sheva shanim uvirushalayim malach shiloshim vishalosh shanim ushlomo yashav al kisei David aviv vatikon malkuto Me'od. Baruch atah Adonai Elokeinu Melech haolam Tzur kol ha'olamim Tzadik b'chol ha'dorot Ha'el ha'ne'eman Ha'omer ve'osei Hamdaber umkayem Shekol devarav emet v'tzedek Al ha'Torah ve'avodah ve'anvim ve'al yom ha'Shabbat hazeh shenatata lanu Adonai Eloheinu li'tushav u'limnucha li'kavod u'l'tifaret Al ha'kol Adonai Eloheinu anachnu modim lach u'mvarchim otach Yitbarach shim ha'befiko chai Tamid le'olam ba'ed Baruch atah Adonai Mekadesh ha'Shabbat
Since before I was born, my parents have sung the following blessing to me. May the long-time sun shine upon you, all love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way home.
My mom learned it at a yoga class she took when she was pregnant with me. Now they sing it to Asher and me every Shabbat. It's a blessing wishing people to have a good life and showing them that when they get upset, they can ground themselves and find their way back to love, happiness, and peace. And that this love, happiness, and peace can be found within ourselves. I chose to write my drash, my Bar Mitzvah teaching, about two concepts that show up in this week's Torah portion. This Torah portion, also called a parasha in Hebrew, is in the book of Genesis and actually takes us to the end of the book of Genesis. The verse I am focusing on is, May the angel who redeemed me from all harm bless the youths, and may they be called by the name of my fathers, Abraham and Isaac, and my mothers, Sarah and Rebekah, and may they multiply abundantly like fish in the midst of the land. A copy of this text is on the handout at your seat, in case you want to refer to it. I added the phrase, and my mothers, Sarah and Rebekah. It didn't exist in the original text. I chose this verse for my drash because it would allow me to dive into two concepts I thought would be interesting to talk about. One, the concept of blessing. And two, the concept of blessing, to both give a blessing as well as receive one. And two, also, if I wanted to sound like a rabbi, it would be wise if I started with something that had the phrase, bless the youths. Because it seems to me like spiritual leaders, and especially rabbis, like to give blessings. So do I sound rabbinic? If so, I've done what I need to do for my bar mitzvah and I can go home now. No, I'm just joking. Okay, back to reality. In order for me to explain what I feel about blessings and angels, I want to share with you some of my thought process. How do you define what an angel is? Take a moment and think of how you define angel. Done yet? Okay, good. I define angel as God's protector. I define angel as something that can do godly things, but in a more recognizable form. I define angel as God's messenger. Look around you. Aren't we all capable of being God's protector? Aren't we all capable of doing godly things? If so, then are we not all capable of being God's messenger? Okay, you don't need to answer that. But in my opinion, the answer is yes. In the text, Jacob says, "May the angel." We often think of angels as outside ourselves. But if in fact we are our own angels, is it not possible that Jacob is actually saying, "May I myself be strong enough to redeem me from all harm?" I like the idea of, in this context, thinking of myself as an angel. My parents think I am. So, if we're in agreement that angels actually are inside us, part of us, and that angels are extensions of God, then we can also assume that God exists inside all of us. If God exists inside all of us, what does that say about ourselves if we treat someone with a lack of respect or a lack of compassion? When I imagine God, I imagine the universe. I imagine even the nebula, that energy in space that will form a star. That is also God, but that is also us. One of the other blessings my parents have told me since I was born, and now Asher, comes from this parasha. May God bless you as he blessed Ephraim and Manasseh. Another blessing my parents say is, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his spirit to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord turn his spirit unto you and grant you peace. So if we look at a blessing the way I just talked about it, maybe when my parents are blessing me, they're really saying to me they want me to find the strength inside myself to be the best person I can be and bring that person to the world. I have the power. That gives this family tradition a whole new meaning for me. But Jacob shows it's not just about us. It's about the people who came before us, showing what connects us and reminding us that the world didn't start with us and it sure won't end with us. May they be called by the name of my fathers, Abraham and Isaac, my mothers, Sarah and Rebecca. I also realize that to give a blessing is not just about saying the words. It's about a feeling and connecting with that part of you which actually make the blessing happen. And it made me realize that receiving a blessing is much more than simply hearing the words, but it's about allowing ourselves to feel deeply that which is inside of ourselves. So in the tradition of also honoring those who came before me, I want to briefly mention a few members of my family who are no longer with us and a few that are. My grandma Barbara, I used to call her Grammy Nana. She used to tell me, I will be at your bar mitzvah, and I know she is. My grandma Barbara loved hosting Shabbat and always had a place at the table for people. And my grandpa Jack, who have turned 102 in 2 days, had a blessing for those around the Shabbat table. My Hebrew name is Noach Moshe. Moshe is the Hebrew name of my grandfather on my mom's side. He died when my mom was only 19 years old, so I never knew him, but I know he too is with us today, as are all my relatives who came before me. And if you like Doctor Who as much as I do, then one might say that even my relatives are with me that will come after me. But that's an entirely different talk. My Nana Lois, my mom's mother, who is here with us. My Nana has worked to make the world better for other people through her volunteer work, especially for the people who aren't as fortunate as we are. Her blessing to me is teaching me and my mom by example that taking action is also a blessing. And I also feel her blessings through the love and support she always gives me. I also want to acknowledge Abraham Joshua Heschel. He's my great uncle, and we studied him at school. One of the things he said, which has stood out for me, is, "I felt my legs were praying." He said this after he marched with Martin Luther King Jr. from Selma to Montgomery. For me, these words also mean to me what I wrote earlier in this talk, that it's not enough to just say a blessing or a prayer, but we must feel it. It also happens to be a yard site this weekend. I want to thank my teachers, Donnie, Dusty, Rebecca, and Akiva, my mom, dad, Asher, and the congregation of Makom, and all of you for sharing this day with me. As I end my drosh, my request is that you join me in offering each of us a blessing. The words are on the back of the pamphlet at your seat. This one. And my request is that when you say this blessing, you hold the hand of the person next to you, and that we all join hands, if possible, to make one big connection of love, inspiration, and empathy. And from this place, we are connected to our soul, to our nashama in Hebrew. I want to ask my mom and dad and Asher and Patricia and Brisa to come up here with me, and I want all of us up here to attempt to link hands. And from this place, join me.
I'm gonna fix that.
Yeah, you should.
May the long time sun shine upon you, all love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way
. First, I want to say a friend advised me that before her son's bar mitzvah, she went and saw a hypnotist so that she could keep it together. I missed that appointment, so I will do the best I can. Noah, the first thing I have to ask you is, how did we get here so fast? When you were just a little thing, which was yesterday, I would go to bar and bat mitzvahs and hear the stories of the kids woven through and told by the parents through their eyes. And I would imagine your own bar mitzvah and what I would say about you. I would gather through the years little memories of you and set them aside for this eventual day like a squirrel gathering nuts for the winter. This is what I would say about Noah, and this, and this. And what I found over time is that there was this clear thread that wove through every thought I had about you, and it is this, Noah. You lead with your heart, always, and it is breathtaking. Whether it's you as a toddler in the back seat of the car when I'm raging about a bad driver and you say to me, "Mommy, Mommy, you don't know, maybe that person had a bad day. Think about it." Or when, as a little kid, there was a kid taunting you, and it was so hurtful to you, but you always put yourself in the other person's place and said, Is something bothering you? Are you having a hard time? Is something going on at home that's making you act this way? Which completely confused those children. Are always seeking out the isolated person in a public situation, a person who doesn't fit in necessarily. It's usually the youngest person in the room or the oldest person in the room, and sitting with them and engaging with them in meaningful conversation and drawing them out and making them a part of the whole. You have always done that. And from the youngest age, intuitively understanding the concept of social justice. I remember when your father and I were completely floored when talking about marriage equality, you, with the clear-headedness of a child, said, "How can it be against the law to love someone?" And then there's the patience and the kindness you show to your brother Asher. When you were a newborn, Rabbi Schulweis said this about your name: "When God gave up on the world, he turned to Noah." I have never forgotten that, because you are exactly the kind of the person the world should turn to repair its wounds. Your empathy is your source. Your heart-melting smile is the invitation to others, and your creativity is your messenger and your vehicle. I would be remiss if I didn't take a moment to talk about your insatiable hunger for artistic expression, and to, on your Nana's behalf, remind you of something that you might not remember, which she told me this week, that at age 4, you could sing a fully orchestrated, pitch-perfect John Williams score. With your creativity, compassion, and wisdom, Noah, you are a natural leader and healer. And I know you will change the world just as you have blessed ours. Noah, I hope that I have been your teacher a fraction of the amount that you have been mine. And it is my joy and honor always to call you my son. Your father and I love you and Asher to the moon and back. And we are so very proud of you today, and you know, every day. I love you.
Noah, thank you for being my son, for choosing me in this lifetime and being here to teach me. There's no doubt in my mind that you have lived lives here before, because the wisdom and compassion you bring to our family is beyond your years. And yet, you're still a kid at heart, and one that truly loves to play. I love watching you play. I often wish we could throw study away and you could just play. Play inside your very deep imagination, an imagination that you feel, go ahead, have some. An imagination that you feel from within. The worlds you create for yourself are real, and you make them come alive. And how you love music, and how you love to play music. As your mother said, you lead from the heart. When you listen to your heart, Noah, you can accomplish anything you want in this world. I want to acknowledge the tremendous amount of time you put into studying this for this day. And every time I reminded you to study, you said to me, well, almost every time I reminded you to study, you said to me, "Dad, I'm doing this because I want to do it." The other night, you expressed sadness that this day was going to be over soon. And what would you be able to do? Here, so it's not on the ground, I'll help you. What would you be able to do? And I thought of a good solution, because I'm sure a conversation with Donnie, you'd be able to do this again on a Shabbat or do it during high holidays. And in fact, if you want to wake up early tomorrow morning, I'm sure we could arrange it, and you could start studying for the next thing. I'll say, Noah, get up and study, and you'll say, Dad, I'm doing it because I want to do it. I cannot end without mentioning your brother Asher, who we love so deeply, and who we know you love so deeply and care for so deeply. For the first 8 years of our lives together, you would ask your mother and me for a baby sibling. You would say you wanted someone to grow up with and to remember what your childhood was like. You have no idea what a profound statement and desire that was. You wanted a witness, and you understood that you would be your brother's witness and he yours. Look into this room. No, take a minute. Look into this room. Look at all the amazing souls you've attracted here. All these souls are here to be your witness. And we're not here just with these souls, the ones you can see with the naked eye. We're here with all the souls in our ancestry and in our family and in our larger community. They're here right now with you. I know for certain that your grandmother and your grandfathers are here with you, among so many others. As you make this transition into a young man, I want you to understand that your mother and I haven't lost that we too are making a transition. And because of your immense empathy and compassion, I don't need to say you're not going to understand it until you're a parent, because I get you understand it now. I remember when you offered your grandpa a chair when you were 3 years old, and just because you knew he needed help, and how you helped kids who are picked on. There's just so many examples of how you portray your compassion and empathy all the time, my son. We love you beyond imagination. We're so, so proud of you. Love you. Can Aaron and Joseph and Asher come up here now, please?
Please rise. We are on page We're going to be on page 51 in 1 second.
Odol eretz v'shamayim v'yarem keren le'amo tehila lechol chasidav livne Yisrael am kerovo. Alleluia.
Lisa Safian, please. And you may be seated momentarily. Just a little bit. Don't get used to it. Wow. So if this is the first Bar Mitzvah, no kidding. This is just absolutely knocked it out of the park. What beautiful chanting. What sweetness here. You know, while we're sitting here like that, I should have done it at the beginning. Turn around and say hello to each other, because people here don't necessarily know each other. So introduce yourselves. I don't want anybody leaving a stranger. Okay. A couple of announcements. First of all, happy birthday, Enid.
Yay!
And Mark? Happy birthday, Mark. How wonderful is that? Mazal tov to the family. The Oneg is going to be right following this, right across the street. Okay, so I think it will be self-evident where it is.
Yeah, so we'll do the blessings here.
Yes. We'll do the blessings of the Kiddush and the Motzi here, and then we're going to go over across the street. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Wow, you're a wonderful congregation. Really, stay. You don't have to go anywhere. So I want to now ask who's coming up for an Aleinu to open up Now would be an excellent time. And as they do that, I ask everybody to please rise. We are now on page 52. 52. Open it up, please. Yeah. Yeah, both sides.
Aleinu eshabeach la'adon hakol la'tet gedula le'yotzer bereshit shelo asanu kegoyei haratzot ve'lo samanu kemishpechot ha'adama shelo samchekeinu kalem וגורלנו ככל המונם ואנחנו קוראים ומשתחדים ומודים בפני מלך
Kadosh Baruch Hu. Ve'ne'emar Ve'ayadonai Le'melech al kol ha'aretz Ba'yom ha'u Ba'yom ha'u Yehe Adonai Echad U'shemo We are now at Kaddish Yatom, page 53. I would like to acknowledge the presence of Dr. Susanna Heschel here with us, and this is the yahrzeit of our Holy Father, Rabbi Avraham Yoshua Heschel, in whose light we are still walking, and those of us who aren't get into that light. It's a good place to be. So I would also like to acknowledge Zach Alexander, who lost his father earlier this week. Arthur Alexander. I will look around the room, and if there are other names you wish to acknowledge, please do so out loud.
Esther Straus.
If it is your custom to stand, if you are observing a yahrzeit and in the morning, please do so. If it is your custom to remain seated, if you are not observing a yahrzeit or are in mourning, please do that. If it is your custom to stand on behalf of those who have no one to stand for them, please do that. I ask the mourners to stand up first, please, and then for the rest of the congregation to join them. Page 53, please.
יתגדל ויתקדש שמי רבא בעלמא דברא חירותי וימליך מלכותי בחייכון וביום מכון ובחיי דכל בית ישראל בעגלה ובזמן קרי ואמרו אמן יהי שמי רבא מבורך לאללה מול עלמי עלמיה יתברך וישתבח ויתפאר ויתרומם ויתנשא ויתהדר ויתעלה ויתעלל שמי דקודשה בריחו לעילה מן כל ברכתה ושירתה, תושבחתה ונחמתה, דאמירן בעלמה ואמרו אמן. יהי שלמה רבה מן שמיה, בחיים עלינו ועל כל ישראל ואמרו אמן. עושה שלום במרומיו, הוא יעשה שלום עלינו ועל כל ישראל ואמרו אמן. You may be seated. Asher. And I have Asher up here, and Noah is already here, and Fred Kramer to please come up. Turn, please, to page 57.
Page 57.
אין כאדוננו, אין כמלכנו, אין כמו שיינו.
Non como nuestro Dios, non como nuestro Señor, non como nuestro Rey, non como nuestro Salvador.
Eloheinu, mikadoneinu, mikem malkeinu, mikem oshienu.
Quien como nuestro Dios, quien como nuestro Señor, quien como nuestro Rey, quien como nuestro Salvador.
No del Eloheinu, no del Adoneinu, no del Malkeinu, no del Moshienu.
Lauremos nuestro Dios, lauremos nuestro Señor, lauremos nuestro Rey, lauremos nuestro Salvador.
Baruch Eloheinu, Baruch Adoneinu, Baruch Malkeinu, Baruch Moshienu.
Bendicho nuestro Dios, bendicho nuestro Señor, bendicho nuestro Rey, bendicho nuestro Salvador.
Atahu Eloheinu, Atahu Adoneinu, Atahu Malkeinu, Atahu Moshienu.
Tú sos nuestro Dios, tú sos nuestro Señor, tú sos nuestro Rey, tú sos nuestro Salvador.
Thank you, Noah. You honored all of us and made us really learn today. Thank you, Lori. Thank you, David. Thank you, Asher. All of you, thank you to Sarah and to Mark and to all of you who are here today. Shabbat Shalom, go in peace, God bless you.